her and Cynthia are actually trapping. No, that girl's probably not going to get out of that one.
We're getting pretty physical.
The story of our Misti and her North Mesquite teammates begins with fireballs.
At some point before the game, we all had a fireball.
It originated with Coach Capps, and then it became a team thing.
And it was kind of to light a fire under us.
I gave one to my nephew one time, and he almost started crying. It was so strong. So.
Fireballs don't look like much, but they pack a punch. That was Misti on the basketball court.
Teams would look at the five and assume, wrongfully, that Misti was probably the weak link.
Misti was beautiful. She was on the homecoming court. But game time, she turned into a beast.
There was a TV interview, and Donna said,
in fact, we've had homecoming queens to play on the basketball team.
We have these nice young ladies, and as soon as they step on the court, they're animals on the court.
And they look real pretty, and they're animals on the court.
Back in the 80s, the different positions on a basketball court were more rigidly defined. As the point guard, Misti handled the ball on every possession, and she was an extension of Coach Capps.
I would really try to go over there as much as possible during a free throw or to get the next play.
I can't even say Misti Goodman without smiling. You know, like, she was the energy.
She was the one who would go for the loose ball every single time.
The Lady Stallions were on a mission that season after losing early in the playoffs the season before. They played like it, too, especially Misti.
There was no quit in her, and she was tenacious and totally unselfish.
Anytime teams would get a fast break, if Misti was the last one down there, you could pretty much count on the fact that she was going to try to take a charge.
She constantly had bruises all over her elbows.
Here's another picture of Misti on the floor. She spent most of her time there, I think.
Yeah, I was all padded up. Oh, my goodness. I had to go extra early to see Terrio in the morning. I don't know. You know, when I think back on it, I don't think I've ever asked my mom, Mom, did I make you nervous out there?
I was nervous. But Misti was doing everything she could to help the team win.
The whole team was like that.
They look real pretty, and they're animals on the court.
A sign of a great team is when there are so many good players, you can't tell who is the best. Cynthia won the Texas Player of the Year award, but Misti was the District Player of the Year. And Teresa had the best college career of all.
There were just different awards given out the whole year. No one was ever envious of another teammate.
We did whatever it took to win. Each person on that floor, winning was the most important thing.
We talk about the joy is really in the journey, and that season together was incredible at how we were able to be unselfish with each other and be genuine. So about 34 years it's been since I've had a fireball, but...
I don't know if I can handle it now.
It just seems like everything Misti did, she did to the best of her ability. Whatever she wanted accomplished, she did.
I think of Misti like the rising tide lifts all the boats. But her efforts were for the team, and her efforts lifted everybody else.
Brings back pretty good, pretty awesome memories.